Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Hello everyone. Welcome back to the another tutorial of Fast Paper. So the MCQs is an overexcited synchronous motor draw current at lagging power factor, leading power factor, unity power factor, depend on the nature of the load. So as this is overexcited synchronous motor, so it will draw current at leading power factor. Okay, next MCQs is the power factor of an alternator depend on load, speed of the rotor, core losses, armature losses. So the correct option is load. So actually, this is overexcited synchronous motor, and the power factor depend on the load. That whether your load is resistive, whether your load is inductive, whether your load is capacitive. So if the load is inductive or if the load is capacitive, then it will result a poor power factor. And poor power factor result in an increase in current drain by the load. So that's why at lagging power factor, the generated voltage must be greater than the generated voltage at unity power factor, because of here the losses is increased due to the poor power factor. Okay, next MCQs is in ultrasonic welding, the frequency range is generally 100 to 4000 cycle per second, 4000 to 20,000 cycle per second, 20,000 to 80,000 cycle per second, 80,000 to 800,000 cycle per second. So the correct option is option B, 4000 to 20,000 cycle per second. Okay, next MCQs is the danger of electric shock is maximum during arcing, after arcing, before welding, while inserting an electrodes on the holder. So option D is the correct answer, while inserting an electrode into the holder. Okay, next MCQs is a DC generator used for AC welding should have dash characteristic, rising, dropping, linear, none of these. So let's explain it a little bit more. Actually, we use differential compound wound generator for welding purpose. For welding purpose, we use differential compound wound generator. Why we use this differential compound wound generator for welding purpose? Because of its high demagnetizing armature reaction. Because of its high demagnetization armature reaction. So and for welding purpose, the demand is high voltage. Demand is high voltage and constant current. High voltage drop and constant current. And that is fulfilled by differential compound wound generator. So that's why we use the differential compound wound generator for welding purpose. So DC generator used for AC welding should have dropping characteristics, okay? Because this is the demand of the welding, that it should have high voltage dropping and constant current. Okay, next MCQs is the basic requirements of a DC armature winding is that it must have a closed one, a lap winding, a wave winding, either B or C. So option A is the correct answer, a closed one. This is the basic requirement of a DC armature winding. Okay, next MCQs is a 4-pole 12 slots lap wound DC armature has two coil sides per slot. Assuming single turn coils and progressive winding, the back pitch would be 573, none of these. So let's explain it a little bit more, that the formula for the retrogressive winding we have retrograde winding and we have progressive winding. So if you want to find the back pitch, so that is represented by YB, and that is equal to Z divided by P plus 1. And for front pitch, we use formula, that is Z divided by P minus 1. For progressive winding, we use the formula for back pitch, that is equal to Z divided by P minus 1. And for front pitch, we use the formula, that is Z divided by P plus 1. So here in this case, the pole is 4, so pole is 4. And the number of parallel path is, this is 12 slots, and we have 2 coil sides per slots, so that will be 12 times 2, that is equal to 24. So 24, that is 24 divided by P, which is 4 plus 1. So 4 times 1 is 4, 4 times 6 is 24. So 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. So option B is the correct answer. Okay, next MCQ is, if the load on a DC shunt motor is increased, its speed is slightly reduced due to increase in armature current, due to increase in flux, due to decrease in reactance, due to decrease in back EMF. So actually, if the load on the DC shunt motor is increased, then the current will increase, and your current is equal to applied voltage minus your back EMF divided by impedance. So here this voltage, applied voltage, is constant. And if the load on the DC shunt motor is increased, then this current will get increased. And this current will increase by decreasing the back EMF. So the correct option is option D, decrease in back EMF. Okay, next MCQs is, the frequency of voltage generated by an alternator having 4 pole and rotating at 1800 RPM is dash hertz. So as we know that the formula for the frequency is NS is equal to 120 F by P. So speed is 1800 RPM and pole is 4 divided by 120, that's equal to frequency. 4 times 1 is 4, 4 times 3 is 12, 0 will cut out by 0, so 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times 6 is 18, 60. So option A is the correct answer. Okay, next MCQs is, the main disadvantage of using short pitch winding in alternator is that it reduces harmonics in the generated voltage, it reduces the total voltage around the armature coil, it produces asymmetry in the three-phase winding, it increases copper of end connection. So the disadvantage of using short pitch winding is that the total voltage around the coil is somewhat reduced. And in order to compensate for this reduction of the voltage, we increase the number of turns. We increase the number of turns just to compensate for this voltage reduction. And as by increasing the number of turns, so it means that we will require more copper wire. So the main disadvantage of using short pitch winding in alternator is that it reduces the total voltage around the armature coil. So option B is the correct answer. And in order to fulfill this reduction of voltage, we increase the number of turns. And increase the number of turns means more copper will require. Okay, next MCQs is, regarding skewing of motor bars in a square gauge induction motor, which statement is false? It prevent cogging? No. It increase starting torque? Yes. So option B is the correct answer. It produce more uniform torque? No. This is not the false statement. It reduce motor hum during its operation? No. So this is also not the false statement. So the false statement is it increase the starting torque. So actually, your starting torque will increase. Starting torque will increase if you increase the current. If you increase the current and slip. So if you increase the current, or if you increase the slip, then the starting torque of square gauge induction motor will get increased. Okay, next MCQs is, the efficiency and power factor of a square gauge induction motor increase in proportion to its speed, mechanical load, voltage, rotor torque. So let's explain it a little bit more. Power factor of square gauge induction motor is poor. When it is poor at no load or low load. So power factor is poor when there is no load or low load. Why this power factor is poor when there is no load or low load? So actually, this is, let's say this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis, and here this is my magnetizing current and this is the in phase current. So at no load, your curve will be like this. So this is your magnetizing current and this is your in phase current. So at no load, in phase current is less. But if we increase the load, then what will happen? The in phase current will get increased. So now the in phase component will be this IW, and magnetizing current will be same as it is. So the in phase component, so the in phase current is increased. So that's why the power factor is increased. And this power factor will increase up to 85 to 90% at rated load. At rated load, the power factor of square gauge induction motor is 85 to 90%. And at no load, the power factor is low, and that is around about 15%. 15% lagging. So if the power factor is increased, then it means that the efficiency is also increased. So the efficiency and power factor of a square gauge induction motor is proportional to its mechanical load. Okay, it depends on the load. Okay, next MCQ is, the damping force in an instrument can be produced by air friction, eddy current, and fluid friction. Which among the three is most efficient? Air friction, eddy current, fluid friction, all are equally efficient. So the correct option is option B. Option B is the most efficient. Okay, next MCQs is, the instrument which can be used only with the DC supply is permanent magnet, electrodynamometer instrument, hot wire instrument, split phase induction type instrument. So the correct option is option B. Permanent magnet type instrument is that instrument which can be used only with DC supply. Okay, next MCQ says, the moving system in the indicating instrument is subjected to deflecting torque, controlling torque, damping torque, all of the above. So that is affected by the all of the above torques. So option D is the correct answer. So this is the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.